latest bit of footage from Sarajevo of Katarina Witt winning gold. It won't surprise you when I say our special guest tonight is none other than Katarina Witt. Please make a welcome. Hi, Katarina, you've just come from the figure skating.
Yeah.
You know, how did you see it tonight? Do you think the judges got it right?
They got it right.
Yes.
They totally got it right, yes.
And the winner was a fair bit better than the rest of the...
She was the best tonight. She was absolutely the best, and she deserved the best notes. I mean, it's kind of sad for Michelle because she really hoped for the gold. But she did a mistake, and even Irina Suskaya, you know, she's been always second, now she ends up second again, and she hoped so much for the gold, but Sarah was tonight, she was absolutely the best.
Now, we've been told that, you know, in the controversy about judging, notwithstanding, we've been told, especially in the figure skating, that that outside the big six, it's very hard for any competitor to get a look in. Big six countries, that is. The big six dominant countries.
Which are the six dominant countries?
Yes, what an interesting question that is.
Yes. So what do you think,
well,
which countries
okay,
are
let me try, you know,
Australia?
So, yes, good idea.
You've got two gold medals in the Winter Olympics.
That's right, it's
congratulations.
Amazing.
Yes.
I bet you never thought that had happened.
Oh, never, no. Not the first one.
With the second one, that was the first competition that Alisa had ever won, so that was kind of an interesting touch as well.
Yes.
Now, I suppose the big six would be, you know, European nations, ranging from Russia, Germany, and America, obviously.
Americans,
I don't know.
Canadians.
Norway.
Norway.
Do you think, though, the judging is, you know, a good, accurate record, generally, of the standard?
Well,
historically speaking?
Historically speaking, I think it's a very tough job for them to sit in those chairs and to make the right decisions. But obviously, there have been a couple wrong decisions for the wrong reasons. So I think for that, it's been good that it all came out. And maybe they come up with some new ruling. And it felt to me for the last competitions in skating, they really tried to be fair. Like tonight, they were absolutely fair. They could have gone maybe with the favorite and... vote something differently, but they really went with what they saw.
Yes, they got it right.
Roy.
Look, my feeling is, Katarina, that the standard of dancing now is so much poorer than it was in your day. How would you feel about that?
You know, the whole time I've been waiting for something funny, you know, so...
Well, you won't find
well,
it.
No, this is
only
truth.
Serious.
No, this is truth. I mean, the spinning,
you.
the height of the jumps, is they're a lot lower these days than they were in your day. Is that not your impression?
Where were you sitting?
You're sitting a bit up the back where you actually don't see much at all.
Where the media sits, you hardly see anything in the last row. You know, no, honestly, technically, it's been incredible.
Yeah.
And the height of the jumps, it's been amazing by, for instance, Irina Suskaya. I mean, her jumps are really high, and Sarah Hughes, she does have great jumps.
Look, how important is physical beauty? Look, if I put to you the proposition, say, a child who was a magnificent dancer, but let's say they were in a car accident and 90% of their body was burnt. But they could still dance beautifully.
Well, forget
what chance
skating.
Would they have?
I think technically 90% being burnt, I think you'll be dead.
No. Car accident, head through the windscreen, totally, you know, just a sort of potato sitting on, but still dances beautifully. What I mean is, the package is important, isn't it?
The whole package is important. You got to have everything. I mean, the look is part of it, but in my days... I was actually upset when they said I was judged for my looks because I said I had my troubles too, so...
Yes, those things.
Oh, that was supposed to be funny.
Listen, was it funny when the was it funny when the East German Secret Service were bugging your room and keeping tabs on your private life? How was, why were they doing that?
How disappointing it was to be done after 7 minutes.
Sorry, I might be losing a little bit of translation here.
I haven't read the whole story.
No, I have.
Thank God.
Well, they bugged you for 7 minutes.
It only lasted.
I mean, I did think the East German secret police were very stupid, but no, they were that stupid.
Well, that was not very nice.
No, not very nice.
Can I just ask, bring you back to the modern day?
Yeah.
What I notice is that there's not, when you say there's not much improvement, people still dwell on the same musical pieces and the trying to do the same basic routine. And, you know, life goes on and you know, there's no sense of hip-hop in it, or there's no sense of, you know, I don't know, disco or stuff like
well,
that.
Well, it has developed in a sense, technical-wise, you know,
yes,
like the guys. And I heard you had Alexei on the show, and I mean, it's unbelievable. It's actually unheard of what they've done. Triple combination, quadruple, and another triple. And but music-wise, you're right, especially for the guys. I wish there would be some more contemporary, upbeat music. But I think, you know, a lot of time they have to please the judges as well,
in the way.
And a lot of them have been there for many, many years.
Yes, that's right. And only no Carmen.
If I hear another Carmen, I've had it up to here with Carmen.
You had it, huh?
No, it was great when you did it, but I've seen about. About 40 Carmen since. And I think there are other pieces of music that
there
could choose.
Definitely. Yeah, there are. Well, you know, a lot of skaters, their favorite music, which is in their age, they can't really use because they have to
appeal
and appeal to the judges and the audience. And so you go with something safe. You know, and classical pieces are most of the time safe. So you don't really go for.
No, something that's risky.
Something. Yeah.
Or out there. Yeah, no, I understand. It's very
like
conservative.
Like bare naked ladies, something on the ice.
Sure. Canadian. Now, have you been surprised by how, and we have, by how popular the Germans have been here at the moment? The team is very popular. Wherever they go, they're cheered. And we've been getting a lot of very positive emails about the German team. George Hackel in particular. Mm-hmm. Are you a Hackel fan?
I don't know him, so I just...
No, nor do we. We're just totally in mind.
Well, he's a great athlete, and apparently he seems to be a fun guy who loves beer. So
yes,
he loves
that's what we've heard. We've heard that he loves beer.
He loves to drink beer.
Yes. Well, right. What the impression I'm getting of George Hackel is that he's a bit dull. Just likes beer.
So that's it.
That's the impression we're getting.
Unfortunately.
And you're not shedding any more light on
this. No, that's right. You've just, I think last year you put out a book about fitness.
Yeah,
What would you say the key principles you're trying to get across in the book are?
Well, in the book it was all about, you know, it's not supposed to be a Bible. How do you lose 20 pounds or 50 pounds in 5 days, which is, you know, not healthy anyway. It's about feeling good, and I try to give especially women exercises which they can do if they don't have much time, if they don't have much equipment, just to be an inspiration and a motivation to stay healthy and to take their time and to be egoistic enough to themselves to take the time and do some exercise just to be in shape and feel good.
We like those exercise machines where you can just sit and watch television.
Yeah, huh?
It does
don't you like those new machines now?
Yes, I think they're great.
Have you tried them?
You know, I don't really believe that. I think
don't
it's
you?
A big lie. I don't know.
Really?
I believe in that you have to do your workout, you have to sweat, you have to take the time and really the effort. And I think it's not just about building our muscles. You know, it's for your heart. It's good if you go running. You need all that. Mm. But I mean, it would be great if it works. I mean, they say in the advertisement that it's working. You know, put it here, you put it here.
Go to sleep with
you,
it all.
Yeah, you know, you sit, watch TV, maybe have some
eat.
Chips. Oh, just eat.
And,
just eat.
And at the same time, you build up muscles.
Yes.
Great
yes.
invention. Yeah.
What sort of fitness exercises would you have done today or yesterday?
I go running, I go on the bike, I weight lift, I use the TheraBend, I go swimming, skiing, skating.
Everything. You're very active.
Yeah. I am very active.
Yeah, yes. Excellent.
And on that positive note, look, we'd like you to accept this small token of your visit here this evening with us. This is, of course, the Cedric Sloan pin.
The ice cream.
That's right. You can only get this pin by coming on this program. No one else has got
it. That's why I came here today, because I heard it's such a beautiful pin and I needed it in my collection.
Beautifully said.